But sometimes I'm looking for what scripture to start. Oh, my Lord. Thank you so much. God bless you. Let's look at Psalm. We'll start from here. We always start somewhere. There's, you know, just start and then let's look at Psalm. Psalm number 27. Thank you, my Father. Father, let it be thus said the Lord tonight in the name of Jesus. Is there anybody that has a testimony? Let me just see your hand. I want to be happy with you. You have a testimony after all these days of ministration? There's a testimony there. God has touched you. I always ask that question. In this past 3 days that I've been ministering with you, has the Lord touched you? Let me see your hand. Okay. If the Lord has not touched you in this past 3 days, let me see your hand. No hand. So the Lord has touched you this past 3 days. If the Lord has touched you this past 3 days, let me see your hand. Tell the truth and let the devil be. Thank God for what he's doing. We spent some time today. Reverend came to see me in my hotel room, and we spent some time, you know, just talking about the past and just reminiscing, just, you know, remembering all those old days. And the Lord has been good, and he's been faithful. You know, Reverend Victor has been in the healing ministry for a long time, Word of Knowledge. We spoke today, and you just happen to be in a good place. You know, if you are committed with your hand, you see, if you turn to the Lord, he will turn unto you. You are in a good place. You are in a good place. You are in a good place. You have a good pastor. You have a very good pastor. He's my good friend. He's true. Honestly. He's my friend. He's my friend. And his first Mercedes-Benz car, I went to bring it from Kutanu. It's my friend, you know. So I know his heart. He's not one of those people looking for big names. God gives him a big name, but he wants to serve. So I feel at home here. I feel very much at home. So if you're in this church, be blessed. Well, if your amen has kwashioko, it's your problem. If you're in this church, be blessed. Somebody said, when will you start preaching? I have started since I stood up. I've started. Psalm 27. I'll read maybe one or two verses and then we'll see. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should arise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Hallelujah. When I read the Bible and I begin to meditate, sometimes I meditate aloud. Sometimes I meditate in front of the mirror, preaching to myself. Now, when I saw this scripture, I saw that everything in my life is all right. Now, look at this. The Lord is my light. Listen, the Lord is my light. The Lord is my light. The Lord is my salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. Let's take it from there. If the Lord is your light. We know in the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God. We know that. John chapter 1. In him was. And the was the. In him was life, and this life is the light of man. So he happens to be the Lord, who is the light of your life. So what could happen to your light to dim? What if you understand that the Lord is your light? Please listen. If you understand that the Lord is your light, there is nothing that can stop your light from shining brighter and brighter. If you say your light is out, it means the Lord is out. Is it possible? The Lord happens to be your light. So if you shine your light in darkness, darkness cannot comprehend it. It means wheresoever you go, you should be a success. Because the Lord is your light. It's not your personal light. The Lord is your light. See, Jesus Christ, Jesus, we understand Jesus Christ, that, you know, he's the branch. The Bible says the branch has come. He's the branch. Is it true? We know that. We are Bible students. Do we know that? All right. We know that he's a light. Do we know that? All right. So everything that he is, he now says, you are. He says, I am the light of the world. He said, now you are the light of the world. He is a branch. The branch. Now he came. He says, now I am the vine. You are now the branches. He's replacing you with himself. He's making you himself. He wants you to be like him completely. And he wants you to go in his own power. So he happens to be your salvation. So your salvation is guaranteed if you stay in him. In him, a key word in the Bible. If you stay in him. So when you face a situation, you may face a situation. It doesn't matter. You're going to face some situations. He said, you are in this world, but you're not of this world. Be of good cheer. I have overcome. So if we stay in him, we are staying in an overcoming position. Situations may arise, but you go in as a winner already. You're not going to beg. And he is your light, so that he will shine. He is the strength of your life. You cannot be weak. You cannot be weak. There's nothing that can stop you from achieving. And you've been fasting all these days, expecting something. Know that the Lord is your light. The Lord is your salvation. The Lord is the strength of your life, so you cannot be weak. Don't give up. Don't give up. Whatsoever the case, don't give up. Don't give up. He is your light. He is your strength. So, well, I'm tired. Don't be tired. Go back to your light. Are you understand what I'm saying? All you have to do is to be in him. Because Acts of the Apostles, the Bible says to us, in him we live, in him we move, in him we have our being. If that is true, let's imagine it's true. In him I live, I move, and have my being. So before a problem touches you, it has to go through Jesus. If a problem has to touch you, it has to go through Jesus. Because you are in him. And if any problem is there by any chance, understand the knowledge, and I mean, have the knowledge to know I am in Christ. If I am in Christ, that's not all. God lives in me. Is it true? Is it very true? Two people said yes, sir. The other don't know. Let me explain to those who don't know. Jesus said, if you believe, my Father and I will come and make our abode in you. Is it true? Yes. Now you know. So if he's living in you, you are the temple of the Holy Spirit. We know that. So Jesus lives in you. The Holy Spirit lives in you. God lives in you. When sickness comes and lives in you, do you think sickness can be a neighbor to God? So my neighbor, God says, my neighbor is sickness. We live together in him. So I take the upper room, he takes the lower room. I'm telling you secrets, because I've said to you when I started, I didn't want to come and preach and show you things. I want you to take something with you. You've been fasting. You're not fasting in vain. Tell your body, God lives here. Sickness, you can't be a neighbor. You can't be, it's not possible. God and sickness cannot be sharing the same door. You know, this house is face me, I face you. So God is on this side, sickness is on this side, the Holy Spirit is here, the devil is also here. So, you know, excuse me. Tell your body, be healed. Be healed. You can be healed. And if the Lord is your strength, you don't need some other anchor anywhere. Let me look at one scripture here in Galatians chapter. Oh, I'm reading Bible. Hallelujah. I haven't read Bible since I came here. No, I read a little bit. Please take something with you. I'm slow to get the word to you. I can do excitements. I know how to do that. Did we say we are in Christ?
Yes, sir.
Do we agree with that?
Yes, sir.
So we are in Christ. Thank you. When God was making a promise to Abraham, he said, through you, the world will be blessed. Through your seed. We understand he was not talking about Isaac. He was talking about Jesus. Do we know that? So Jesus is that seed. Now, what if this is a seed, this is a seed, this is a seed, this is a seed. What do we say? Seeds. Yeah, with S. All right? Are you with me? If your neighbor is sleeping, pull his nose or do something. Galatians chapter 3. I want you to see something. Galatians chapter 3, verse 29. Galatians chapter 3, verse 29. Don't forget this verse. Galatians chapter 3, verse 29. The Bible says, and if ye be Christ, then are ye Abraham's seeds. No. Seed. But the seed he promised was Jesus. He says, but if you're now in Christ, you are that seed, according and heirs according to the promise. So he had promised a seed is coming. Jesus. So when he's looking at Jesus, this is the promise. He now says, if you are Christ, you are that seed. When God is looking at you, he's looking at his seed. He's looking at Jesus.
Yes,
he's not looking at you. What's your name, brother?
Dari.
Oh, brother Dari. He's not looking at Dari and Jesus. He's looking at Jesus, because he says, this is the seed. If you be Christ, you are that seed. Now, what does the seed of God do? Germinate to bring forth fruits. To germinate, to bring forth fruit. So you have to succeed in life. Your health must blossom in life. Your prosperity must come. Say, well, I've been praying about it. Pray again, because it must come. You think I'm rich? Well, I'm rich in Christ. I'm believing God for money. I'm believing God for prosperity. I'm believing God for great ministrations. I believe in God for move of the Holy Spirit in my ministry. I'm stepping up because I know that I am that seed. If I'm that seed, I'm a heir of the promise, and I'm a joint heir with Christ, and I'm not going to stop. I will go on and go on and go on. You are that seed. God is looking at Jesus. So this is the seed I promised when I was speaking to Abraham. This is the seed. This is the seed I promised when I was talking to Abraham. Because you belong to Christ, so you are that seed. And if you're that seed, you are Christ's, and Christ is in you. If Christ is in you, so the hope. I was speaking to this lady yesterday. I said, is she Hausa? I just got that feeling. I just said, is she Hausa? She said, no, I live in Al-Hausa.
Is it true?
She didn't know it was prophetic. She looked like Hausa, doesn't she?
Yeah.
A little bit. But I just said, Hausa. She said, no, I live in Hausa. She thought I knew her. I don't know you. If somebody knocks your door, no, no, no. If Christ is now in you, bless you. If Christ is now in you, you know what you are carrying? The hope of glory. So the hope is something you are expecting. Hope. Hope. Hope of glory. And this glory will not come until you release it. Until you release it, it will not come. That's why the Bible says in Colossians chapter 3 verse 4, if Christ, who is our life, shall appear, we shall appear with him in glory. Hallelujah. We shall appear with him in glory. How do you demonstrate the glory of God? Miracles, signs, wonders. Miracle is not when you pray for somebody and something happened. Miracle is miracle, something supernatural. Where people don't expect a result, you get a result. It's your portion. Because the Lord is. The Lord is your strength. Is. So you have nothing to fear. The Bible says he has not given you the spirit of fear, but of love, of power, and of sound mind. So you are sound. Because there is power, and by the love of God, things begin to happen. You say, oh, are you a pastor? I say, I'm not a pastor, but I'm a son of the Most High God. I'm a daughter of the Most High God. Things are happening because people expect only pastors can do that. Thank God for those big names. Reverend Prophet Johnson from Germany. You know, if this Reverend Prophet Johnson from Germany doesn't have Christ... So he will be as useless as a matchbox that has nothing inside it. It's Christ. People of God, I'm talking to you as my brothers. I'm talking from my heart. From my deep heart. Because what does it... Listen to this. We are going to war now. We are going to war. Global Harvest against Lagos. We are going to war now. And we now have a big Reverend Johnson. He has all the gadgets you can have. And every other army has nothing. Have you won? You have lost from home. You have lost from home. You said, don't worry. Oh, he has all the gadgets. He has ballistic missiles. One preacher was preaching just after the war in Iraq, and he was preaching. He said, ballistic missiles. Oh my God. Ballistic missiles. I said, ballistic. I said, what verse is that now in the Bible? People look for big grammars to preach. I don't know how to do it. I'm sorry. I tell you the truth. So now I have all the missiles and all the gadgets. Said, don't worry. Our captain has everything. But every other person coming, they have nothing. They're just following him. You're going to war. Anybody who has anything at all is a penknife, you know? I will call, you want to cut the enemy. You have lost. But what about if everybody is armed? Everybody's armed with something. We have an unbeatable team. We have an unbeatable team. So my heart is that we all stand as a strong army of the Lord, gaining ground every day in our lives, in our homes, to the glory of the name of Jesus. Not because of Johnson, but because he died for it on the cross and he gave us a testament. And he is our strength. We must achieve. We are achievers. Christ in you, the hope of glory. This Christ is the light. This Christ is your strength. It's your salvation. It is solid. Amen? Very solid. Very solid. I can also come and pray for you. Just lay hands and you get healed. You go home. And then, you know, what about if by any chance anything happens, you can stand? Because you know that you can do it. You are in that position to do it. And so the Bible says, he didn't talk to pastors. Bible says he made you able ministers of the gospel. He made us able ministers of the gospel. able minister of the gospel. What's the gospel? Good news. What's minister? To minister. Minister is minister. So you are an able minister of the gospel whenever, wherever you can minister gospel, good news. You are carrying good news with you. We should be spreading good news. Spread good news. Let people know when he comes, everything will be all right. Everything will just be all right. We are just waiting for him. I just remembered there was a brother was going to get married in Akure City a long time ago. And his name was also JJ. They called me JJ, he's JJ. So they were expecting me. So if I come, everything will just be all right. Long time ago, very long time ago. If I come, everything will be all right. I didn't know that. So when I came, a taxi came. Everything they've been waiting for, brought the taxi brought it. The people who had been in traffic jam, everybody came. They said, I told you when JJ comes, everything will be all right. I didn't do it. It was just coincidental. From that day, everybody was looking up at me. So I had to grow a little taller, you know. That's human. How about if the devil knows, if Dari walks here, we can't stand. Before Dari say, they are gone. Because just his coming, just his appearance, just his stepping into those things will happen. If a man is in Christ, is a new creature. All things are passed away. What verse is that? 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. We know it, don't we? If a man be in Christ, is a new creature. All things are passed away. All things have become new. We can quote it. We know where it is. We don't read the next verse. Verse 18 says, and now all things are of God. All things are of God. So as a new creature, all things are now of God. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. So when you are praying to God, God bless me. He said, but I don't have again. I've blessed you already. So Father, do it. Father, do it. Father, I said, Son, do it. Son, do it. Say, Father, do it in Jesus' name. Father, say, Son, do it in Jesus' name. He has blessed you with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. So you don't fast, and after fasting, nothing happens. You fast to step into what you are. And as a matter of fact, that's where we stop. Verse 3, we don't read verse 4. Always take a step further. The Bible says, before the foundations of the earth. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 4. All those things I said, bless them. It says, before the foundation of the earth. So before the earth was formed. Are we there? Before the earth was formed, he had already decided and chosen you to be blessed before your father's father was born. That's his decision. He chose you before the foundation and he blessed you with all spiritual blessings. Now, generations and generations and generations before Christ missed it. And now that Christ came, he opened the door. So we now became a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, holy nation. We know all of that. The last part says, what does it say? To show forth the glory of him who has called us. To show forth. So, I'm a Christian. What of you? I'm also born again. Hallelujah. No. You're not born again to kind of No. To show forth the praises of him who has called you out of darkness. To show forth. So that the world can see. Let the whole world see your good works and give glory to your Father. They must see something. Let the world see your good works. You have been called into good works. Good works also has to do with your behavior. The way you conduct yourself, the way you, not as a law, we are not in law, we are in grace. But grace gives you the power to do right. If you can't be doing wrong and say you are in grace. If you're looking for a grace preacher, I am. But I don't agree with some people that you can do it. You can do everything. You can, how can you do everything? What, where's the change? So why did you born again? You born again to go and do everything? Second, we have, put reverend there, I'm reverend. May you be pastor in Jesus' name. How can you call me pastor? Who wrote it? Look at them. Put reverend there. You want to belittle me? I'm your brother. In 2 Corinthians chapter 7, that's just bypass. 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1. The Bible, I like that scripture very well. Like this, just look at this very well. The person is busy writing reverend. Forget reverend, put 2 Corinthians. Time is going on. Having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all kinds of filthiness of the flesh and the spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. And the scripture is there, and you say you can do anything in grace. Look at this strong scripture. You can't clean it. He said, having therefore these promises, all the promises of God, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves. Our God is a holy God. If you want to be like God, you must be like God. God is holy, you must be holy. Well, we don't talk about sin, but there are some things that are evil. You don't do evil in the sight of God. In Romans chapter 8, the Bible says we have been redeemed. The spirit of life in Christ has redeemed us from the spirit of sin and of death. So redeemed, you have been taken out of sin and of death, and you are now sinning in the new life. No. Then you are not taken out. Be holy. Amen. That's extra preaching. Now the thing is, when you are holy, you have a right standing before God. You have a confidence. Yeah, all right. It's good. Yeah, you wrote it well. That's me. Oh, you couldn't take the whole thing, and it's too long. It's all right. Because you are all laughing, let's do a miracle. You're all laughing. We must do one miracle. Sister, I want to do a miracle on you. Can I do a miracle on you? Please say yes. So that we You need prayers? She doesn't need prayers. You do need prayers? For what? For what? When was the last time you have back pain in the lower back? When was the last time?
I'm always having it.
Huh?
It comes and goes.
And she doesn't need prayers. Reverend, she doesn't. It comes and goes. Sister, it won't come back again. Is that a good miracle? Then praise God for that.
Hallelujah.
Is that enough miracle? Not enough. Let's do one more. Let's go to the other side. Let's do the GPS kind of thing. What's up? Girl.
Why then? She just told me as we were coming that when she was climbing the father's car this morning, she felt faint, like she couldn't breathe well. She's been having.
She's been having.
Ella, speak for yourself.
You speak English? Talk to her. Talk for her, please.
She's been coughing really bad.
Really bad.
Yes.
And she's really fainting.
And she said she felt faint this morning as she was going to school.
Come. I love miracles. What's your name?
Manuela.
Manuela, I love children. I love children. And I love miracles. Manuela, it's gone. Hug me, hug me. Don't be scared. You are feeling fainting. How did I know that? You don't know how I know. You know how I know? I tell you how I know. Because I have a Noah. I just know. But listen to me. It's gone. Do you believe me? You believe me? This girl just got healed now. True, true, true. How are you feeling now? And children don't lie. It's how you feel. Is it bad? But how are you feeling now, Manuela? You don't know? Are you still feeling fainting? It's gone. She smiles. Praise God. Go sit down. Thank you, my Father. God can do all things through you. Through you. If God is going to declare his glory, how will he do it? How will God declare his glory? Will he jump down from heaven and say, "Oh, I want to declare my glory now"? No, he will use you. So what are you scared of? What all these scriptures we quote, all these scriptures we quote, when will they manifest in our lives? I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I have a dick, Pastor. You just said you can do all things. It's not just a nice scripture. It's life. Life. You're speaking life to yourself. When you read it, take it for yourself. When I was reading, what was the name I mentioned just now? Jehoshaphat. When I was reading the Bible, and I said, Jehoshaphat went to Mahabishu. I said, oh, these big names, my goodness. The Asalom, the Abimelechai, Amalekai, those big names. I said, God, what's my business here now? Until I came across a scripture in Romans chapter 1. The Bible says, all these things were written, verse 19 and 20, all these things were written so that we don't have any excuse. They are all written as examples so we don't have any excuse. Oh, I like people here. They're just pressing quickly. What's the next verse says? The next verse. So that they are without excuse. We have no excuse. It's because, what is because? Everything you know in the Bible, everything, the whole Godhead was written so that we have no excuse. No excuse. It's not because, go for it. And God will begin to use us greatly. And the fastings and the prayers that you've been having, God says he has answered them. It's for you to now step out in the name of Jesus the Christ. I want to say thank you so much for Reverend Victor for having me here. I've really enjoyed myself. It's been wonderful. And we will stay in touch. We'll really much stay in touch. Thank you, Reverend. I love you. I've always loved you. I loved you before Pastor Jimmy. Yeah, you remember? I came first and then Pastor Jimmy. Then she displaced me and said, okay, I have to admit. But it's good to know somebody in the Lord. Somebody who has a heart for God. Not a name for, Victor. No. People, you have a good pastor. Stand with him. Support him. We spoke today and we just discovered we still flow. We talk of people who, ministers need money. We know, you know too. But I don't talk about money because of people who squeeze hands and go deep in your pocket and say, hey, brother, go deep in your pocket. Go deep, brother, go deep. He said, Pastor, I'm deep. My hand is already coming down. There's nothing else. So if you won't pray. A young man, he said this in the prophetic ministry. I was happy with him. I said, right. You call his number and say, so this is the answering machine of prophet. If you want to talk to the prophet, please donate $100. You bring $100 to talk to him. Ah, how much will I bring to God? Your boss, God, I meet him every day in my room. You know, you want $100. Huh? That's why we don't talk money, but you know money is needed in the ministry. And there's nothing wrong with you once in a while to say, my pastor, I just want to bless you. Just do it. They didn't ask me to say this. I'm telling you the truth. Just do it. Just do it. Just sow into something good. There are many reasons to give money in the church. Either you sow or you just enjoy it. If you go to theater, you know, you pay. I mean, theater for show, for cabaret, you pay. If you go to the hospital, you pay. You come to the pastor, you say, pastor, hurry up. One of the studies I did, if people want to, I can't work. I'm full-time occupied here. My mates who are doing the thing there, they call it mediation. You make an appointment to come and see them. Your first meeting is 80 euros just to have a meeting. And what's the problem? How can we help you? 80 euros. And then they say, oh, this kind of problem, you need about 5 to 6 discussions. Each sitting is 120 euros. They say, sign immediately. They come. How much is euro? I don't even know. About 100 euro will be about 200, about 20,000. Oh, I don't know. And then they need 5. Say, very good. It's very cheap, you know, this time. You now come to pastor. Say, pray for here. Is it gone? Say, gone. Yeah, pastor, continue here. Hurry up, pastor. Oh, that was very good. My uncle and my whole man. Why don't you just do it? Say, I just want to bless you. My time is going. I just want to bless you. Bless your pastor. Make it your home. Where your heart is. Where your value is. Your heart will be there. Where your heart is, your life will be there. Put your heart in this church. Amen? And then you will enjoy it. You want to see the fruits of your labor. If you labor to bring money to this church, you want to see the fruit. He didn't tell me to say this, and I'm not telling you how much. I've read 12 verses now. So you bring $12 in 12 days, and within 12 months, God will give you 12. No, those lies. It's a lie of the devil. God forgive them. Which scripture is that? But you just decide, a cheerful giver, just bless your pastor. If you don't want to bless your pastor, bless my friend, Reverend Victor. Just bless him. Just give him something good. Do it. Be a part of the church. Get engaged. Get engaged with God so that God can get engaged with you. It's not a covenant, but you know, God knows you are busy, so he has to do something to glorify himself. But the glory of God can only manifest when we understand all those things and we begin to do it. Amen. It's been very, very awesome. Very, very awesome. 10 minutes. If anybody has any pain in the name of Jesus, you have any, let me do that tonight. If you have pain, the pain goes immediately. Check it. Check quickly. The pain goes. If you have pain, check it. Nose, neck, back, legs, chest. There's somebody there, your wrist is very bad. Who on this side? Your leg, very bad. Quickly, stand up, let me see. Who is it? Your wrist, you know what they call wrist? Leg, wrist, ankle. Not this wrist, this one there. Oh my goodness. Ankle, your leg. Oh, it's you. Your ankle. Huh? So there's nobody here with problem with the ankle? You don't know how to stand up. You don't want to stand up? Okay, raise the ankle up. There's somebody. Look at sister. Come, sister. Why you no one stand up before? Which one? Sweet. No. I won't collect money. It's free. Brother, stay there. Why didn't you want to stand up?
I was shy.
You were shy. Shy. Sister, there's no need to be shy. I understand, that's all right. But I minister a lot. I told somebody, I said, your name is this. After the meeting, said, Reverend, it's me. I didn't want to know. I said, it's all right. I don't embarrass anybody. I don't. Like that person who got healed from wetting, I don't embarrass people. I don't do it. You saw me, I spoke to a sister here yesterday. Hey, bless you. I spoke to a sister yesterday. I don't embarrass people. There's no need. Brother, check your ankle. Now listen to me. If it's not gone, stay there at Moscow. There's no need to be shy in the house of the Lord. All right? All right? You agree with me? Okay. How long has the ankle been? Just this morning. Very bad. You asked one of my GPS was working. I knew. You asked one of your colleagues at work. What do you do? Wow. And it was painful. Goodness. And you were very shy to stand up. Okay, because you are shy, just take 10 steps. If you are not shy, I would have said 20. But because you are shy, take 10 steps this way and come back. 10 steps. Count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, gone. Turn around, sister. How is it? It's gone.
Is gone
because you took 10 steps. How many steps did you take from your house to get here? Is it really gone just now? Is the Lord good? People, I can do show. Wow, it's gone. Look at that. Wow. No. I want you to know that you can do it. You can do it, sister. Do you know why it left? Because it has no place in your body. And because you are shy, you'd have taken it home. And then you say, I wish I had gone. You know? Now it's gone. Just like that. God is good. Come on, praise God for that. Thank you, my Lord. Brother, he's still there. Huh? It's very bad. Huh? Slightly. Stay here. Men are stronger than women. Take 20 steps. Come here. It's gone. Check it. Check it. Huh?
It's gone.
It's gone. Oh, my goodness. If you have somebody very close, I have 5 minutes. If you have somebody very close, it doesn't have to be close. You need have somebody somewhere you can reach now on telephone. Call them right now. Quickly. Call them right now. There's somebody you need to call that has kidney problem. Call the person right now. Kidney problem. On the phone. You have somebody this.
I have a friend.
Yeah, call the person. Call the person. I see kidney problem. It must go right now. Call quickly. I got 5 minutes. Now 4. Call the person quickly. 1, 2, 3. If you think you have a leg shorter than the other, I got 4.5 minutes. You have a leg shorter than the other, stand up and come quickly. You have a leg shorter than the other, come very quickly. Are you making your calls? Are they on the other side? Quickly now. Quickly. Call them. 080. Sit down there, sister. 080. 86. 47. 312. Sister, how long? It's always been like that. Move your back. Move to the back. Touch the back properly. call, make calls very quickly. Stretch your legs. Father, in Jesus' name, I give you praise. Have you made the call? Call the person. Tell him I want to pray for them. Quickly. Oh, quickly. You made a call? Quickly. Come. Quickly. 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 Who's on the line? Your father. What's the problem? Since when? Your pressure behind your eye is gone. Ask him right now. Quickly. Quickly. Ask him. Bring your phone. Ask. Ask him. Don't go.
Hello, Daddy. How is the guy? Okay. He said he's in a noisy place. He wants to leave the place so he can talk.
It's a noisy place. Please, quickly, quickly. Quickly. Are you on the phone with somebody? Who is it? Your friend. What's the problem? Breathing difficultly. Breathe in the name of Jesus. Normal. Ask quickly. Don't go. Ask the person. What's it? Your aunt?
Your name is
head. Constant headache since three and a half years.
More like three and a half years.
In 3 seconds, it's going. Your headache is going now. 3, 2, 1. Go. Ask her, please.
It's fine. He said it's fine.
Said it's fine. Thank you, my Lord Jesus. What's your papa saying?
Feels better.
Is he still on phone?
Yes.
Don't feel better. Feel completely good now in Jesus' name. Ask him. Quickly. I won't come to you again. Hynea, be healed in the name. Shake it, brother. In the name of Jesus, Hynea, be healed in Jesus' name. Your blood remains normal. Right from Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Quickly. Ask them. I want testimonies. Seek over a year. Is she online? You are online. I can't hear you, but you can hear me. Be healed right. Shake it up. She's lying now. Stand up. Stand up. Talk to her. Hold it. Stand up. Tell her I say stand up. Eddie Day, mommy. Eddie Day now. Tell her to rise up right now in Jesus' name. Stand up. Huh?
It's better.
It's gone. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, my Father. Quickly.
We'll have to change.
In Jesus' name, be healed. Now, ask, please, quickly. I command in the name of Jesus that every poison in your blood should go, and that stomach, the stomach is swollen. That stomach that is swollen must go right now in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name. The leg must be healed now. Please ask them quickly. Whatsoever, I'm praying in the name of Jesus. Give me your phones in Jesus' name. Be healed. 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 Ask them. Ask them now. I want testimonies. I want testimonies. Your mommy is not on phone. Be healed right now. Ask them.
She's still on the phone and she's still.
Ask them. I want testimonies now. Thank you, Jesus. I want testimonies. What happened?
I just asked her now. She said, "Adupe motiwa oki."
Thank you, my Lord Jesus. That's wonder. Testimonies. Quickly. Quickly, testimonies.
My
I want testimonies now.
It's better now.
She have
a headache constantly. Yeah,
headache is gone. 3 years. Your phone, whatever, in Jesus' name, whatsoever. Testimonies. See now, see in Jesus' name. I want testimonies now. Breathing difficulty. Thank you, my Father. Now, if you have a testimony from the phone, let me see your hand. From your phone, come one from the phone. Did you speak with them? Come there with your papa. Come quickly. You have a testimony. Come from the phone. Listen to this.
3 years now, and she was
on phone.
Constant headache for like 3 years now, and she was prayed for.
It's gone. Constant headache on phone. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, she had an attack like 7 years back, and her body has been scratching her. She has this spot all over her body up to the space. But the day before yesterday, the old thing came out again. And when I called her, I told her a pastor wanted to pray for her. She's not a Christian, but she said, okay, she's waiting to hear him. And when I called her, mom, what's up? She said, Adupe Mutiwa okay.
She's okay. Mutiwa okay. It's good enough for me. Thank you, Jesus. Testimonies.
You can see
on phone. You can see blindness on phone. Sheke barababa. Came up promo sodomo.
He had pressure and he said that it's gone.
Gone. Pressure in the head. Gone. Quickly. Testimonies. Hi, brother. You came to pick me up.
Yes. He just spoke with me. I spoke with him. He had an accident on his leg. So he just required, I was speaking to him. He said, as 3 days ago, it was actually hurting him. But immediately, I just told him that it was healed. That he just left. That he doesn't feel any pain again.
Gone. On phone. In Jesus' name. Testimony. What happened?
He was asthmatic. So he normally has these breathing difficulties. So when I called him now, he said he's very fine.
Asthma gone on phone. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Testimonies. More testimonies. Testimony.
Praise God. It was my mother I called, and she had poison over 3 years, and she has a swollen tummy. And as at the time I called her, she said she was outside, and it was very strong. So when I called her now, she said it's gone down.
Poison gone. On phone. Glory be to God. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. What's the matter with Mama? Eye problems. Mama, you cannot see. Come here. Mama cannot see. God is healing on phone. Since when? 12 years. What happened? Glycomy. Melt. Open your eyes. It must melt in Jesus' name. Mama, it's melting in Jesus' name. It's melting in Jesus' name. I want you to see before we leave. Your phone, let me just touch it, whatsoever. Testimonies. What's this? Whatever, whatsoever. Your kidney is getting healed right now in Jesus' name. Your kidney is getting healed right now. Yes, it's getting very hot right now as I'm speaking. It's getting healed in Jesus' name. You don't need dialysis. It's getting healed in Jesus' name. Check it. Keep checking it. Let him check it. Melt. Eyes, I command you to open now. Open your eyes. In Jesus' name. Let blindness go. Let blindness go. In Jesus' name. Brother Kunle, this is what I was talking to you about in the car. When we were coming. This is what I was talking to you about in the car when we were coming. Thank you, ma'am. Mama, when we were coming, I have a witness here. I said we have a very serious case, but God is taking care of it. I believe with every iota of my body that you're going to see perfectly in the name of Jesus. Eyes, I command you to open. Do you come to this church?
Yes,
you come to this church. I open, you will give testimony in this church, and then they will text me and say it's true. I, you must open in Jesus' name. Glaucoma, you must melt off. 12 years got coming. Melt. 12, 10, 8, 4, 2. Melt in Jesus' name. Thank you, my Father. It must go. So, what's my matter now? I have now 0 seconds. Bless you, little girl. Whatsoever. Whatsoever.
Yes.
Did I touch your phone? What happened? Your chest. Your chest there. And there's a little thing there. There's nothing there. Okay, press it now. Check it right now. Check it.
It's not there. It's not there.
Doctors couldn't take it.
Yes.
Thank you, my Father. So what happened?
She says she's feeling better.
She's feeling better.
Cough.
Do like this. Do it again. Do it very well. Now do it one more time. That sounded good. Cough, go in Jesus' name. Amen. Leave her alone in Jesus' name. How is he feeling? He's gone again. He's healed. I believe God with her. I believe God with her. I know that she's healed and getting healed. I have a witness here. I told her, what's the matter?
He's blind.
See in Jesus' name.
He touched me.
Is the Lord good?
Yeah.
Is the Lord good? Is there anything happening now? I know something will happen, but I'm expecting something to happen right now. What's happening right now? I'm talking to you, Mama. What's happening right now? You can't see nothing yet. Nothing yet. I'll touch you one more time. Because something must happen. Eyes open in Jesus' name. Eyes open in Jesus' name. Glaucoma, melt off. Disappear completely in the name of Jesus. Melt off. We want to have a testimony, my Father. In Jesus' name. Let's give God a hand of praise in this place. Hallelujah. We give God praise. Reverend Victor, it's been awesome ministering with you, for you. And we will not keep the pilot waiting. And it's just been awesome. It's just been awesome. A good atmosphere to the glory of God's mighty name. In Jesus. Migraine. Migraine and the son cannot talk. Migraine, go. Son, speak. Oh, okay. Ask him about the head right now. It's pounding. Pound yam. Out in Jesus' name completely. Go. Check it. Thank you, Reverend. God bless you.
We worship you.